Hello and welcome back to another English lesson. Today's lesson is about something I'm asked to do a lot. Students want to know all about Australian slang. If you didn't already know, I am from Australia. But I think because I'm an English teacher and I've lived in a few countries, I don't have a very strong Australian accent. Also, Australia is very big, so there are different accents in different parts of the country. Some of the slang that I will teach you today is also common in other countries, especially New Zealand and also the UK. But I'm going to teach you these as well because if you come here, you are definitely going to need to learn them. Before we start, don't forget to subscribe, to like this video, and also say hello or g'day in the comments below. I have a new video every Sunday on grammar, pronunciation, vocabulary, speaking, listening, reading, writing. So, Australian slang. Let's start with some common expressions. G'day. Well, this is probably the most famous internationally for Australia. And we really do use it a lot. It's a greeting, so it's a way to say hello. If you use it, make sure you stress the second syllable, day. You don't want to say g'day. That sounds strange. It's g'day. Good on ya. Good on ya. This means well done. Good on you. Good on ya. How you going? Or how's it going? So this is how are you going? Or how is it going? It means how are you? How you going? How's it going? Stoked. This means really happy. Oh, I was stoked to hear about the job. I was really happy. No worries or no dramas. So this means don't worry about it and also you're welcome. So if someone says thank you, you can say no worries or no dramas. Dodgy. So something not quite right. Oh, that sounds a bit dodgy. Dodgy. Reckon. We use this a lot for think or believe. I think, I reckon. I reckon it's pretty good. Or what do you reckon? What do you think? What do you reckon? In Australia, you can also just put mate at the end of every question and every sentence. Of course, like all of these expressions, and all of Australian slang, it's in an informal situation. So you could say, hey, go on, mate. Not bad, mate. No worries, mate. Okay, let's do the shortened words. This is really common in Australia. We like to cut, shorten lots of words. There's actually another video on this, which is quite funny. So I'll put the link in the description box. But let's do a few now. Service station, where you get fuel or gas. Servo, barbecue, barbie. Football, footy. Well, this is Australian rules football. We call it footy. Mosquito, mozzie. Avocado, avo. Breakfast, brekkie. Biscuit, bicky, chicken, Chook. Sunglasses. Sunnies. University. Uni. Cup of tea or cup of coffee. Cuppa. McDonald's. Macca's. It's also common, especially, to do this with jobs. So a tradesman, so that's someone who has a trade, like a bricklayer or a carpenter, they're called tradies. A carpenter is called a chippy. An electrician is called a sparky. A bricklayer is a bricky. An ambulance driver is an ambo. A police officer is a copper. A garbage collector is a garbo. A firefighter is a fiery. And a cab driver is a cabby. Alright, here are some ways we describe things. So, we often use bloody, and it just means very. Oh, it was a bloody good movie. Oh, the food was bloody awful. If a place is full, it's chock-a-block or chockers. If you're busy, you can say you're flat out. I've been flat out all week. And if you're tired, you can say buggered or knackered. So the K is silent, knackered. If something's great, you can say ace. That's ace. Here are a few things or nouns that are important to know. So these kind of shoes, we call them thongs. Lots of other countries call them flip-flops. We call them thongs. Swimwear, well, this is one word that really varies across the states. The most common are togs, bathers, and swimmers. But this map shows you how different it is around Australia. So I'm from Melbourne, down here, so I say bathers. Well, if you meet an Australian, or even better, come to Australia, I hope you have a chance to use some of these words. Or at least, if you talk to an Australian and they say one of these things, you'll know what they're talking about. Do you want to practice? Well, go over here to this website where I have all the words, some examples, and some other useful videos about Australian slang. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next Sunday for another lesson. Alright, bye!